So one prototypical blockchain use case has become the supply chain. And if we think back on our blockchain decision tree, some of the reasons why become apparent. Modern supply chains are frequently cross-border, involving multiple separate companies with their own business operations, records and record-keeping practices, differing local regulatory and customs constraints, and a range of other discontinuities that make efficient collaboration very difficult. Verifying facts that may sound relatively simple, for example, the current location and status of an item, or payment status, or say, an inventory level, start to become exponentially complex when all those states are housed redundantly in the separate systems of the multiple companies involved. Reconciliation of these records and keeping in sync can require exorbitant people hours and cost, and still be prone to error that takes yet even more resources to unravel. So in our illustration, we have a hypothetical supply chain for automotive parts. This chain might have a network of original equipment manufacturers, typically known as OEMs, a network of distributors at both regional and local levels, and then end buyers of these parts might be split up between dealerships, mechanics, and parts retailers. So even in a rather simplified scenario, we see the participants involved add up very quickly. So you can imagine that with each member of this network keeping their own records, the amount of communication, verification, and reconciliation involved just to keep everyone in sync about the current state of reality. And in the event of a disagreement around that data, a slow and laborious process to reach a resolution. One entity could operate a single data store for all this information, but you see, with all the parties being their own businesses, there might likely be resistance to giving just one of them control over that data. And you can bet there would be very real tension around sensitive information, such as pricing between competitors and negotiated arrangements between any of the parties. So we have a highly fractured industry that requires high levels of coordination amongst unrelated and even competing businesses that suffers from inefficiencies stemming from keeping records of transactions between these enterprises. These are some of the hallmarks of a potential blockchain use case. A blockchain ledger system provides a means for these companies to interact on a single system while avoiding the pitfall of centralizing that system into one bottleneck of control. Smart contract applications can further allow certain processes to run without human interaction, increasing speed and reducing potential for error and ultimately dispute. Ownership changes can be logged in the ledger, as we see illustrated here, and invoicing based on each ownership transfer can be processed automatically. The automation opportunities become increasingly interesting as the data arriving to the ledger can be more and more generated from connected and IoT devices. This can further streamline processes and bring them closer to real time, while also reducing some typical sources of error. There are some well-publicized examples of production blockchain solutions within the supply chain vertical, and we encourage you to research them further.